Megovanin, everyone, and welcome back to more adventures into Wasteland with Falagar. So, I must preface something, and I talked about this in a much earlier video, but at this point, you know, it was episode zero, but at this point it's probably been about a few weeks, right? Maybe a little more, since, you know, you've seen that video, if you've seen it at all. So I thought I'd preface this really quick, that I had a mod that was conflicting mod, because I did not have Fallout 4 script extender. I don't use that. So I had to take off that mod, which was called Crime and Punishment. I still have Gun for Hire, which is the same mod author. I think his name is Flashy Joe. Joer, or Flashy Joer, I think it is. But Gun for Hire did not require Fallout 4 script extender, and Crime and Punishment did, and that's why it was causing quite a bit more lag than what would naturally be there. You know, the game, not lag, freezing, pausing for long periods. There seemed to be more of that. And when I would exit the game, it would take about 20 to 30 seconds just for it to exit to desktop. Whereas I remember it before just exiting pretty seamlessly. Like, I would exit, a second later I'm at desktop. So that's how, you know, that's a red flag there. That's how you know something is wrong, how I knew something was wrong. So ever since I took that off, it corrected that problem. And what I did was, because I removed that mod, you know, mid-play, it crashed that game. So I had to restart Falagar, work my way back up, selecting the same choices, the same decisions, even tried to build my character in the same way up to that point. And I think I was even level 7, you know, in the last episode, with the last Falagar character. So I think I recreated the events up to that same point of the last episode, pretty accurately. I think it's almost, you know, the same, I think, more or less. Some of my gear will be different, of course. You know, sometimes, you know, you can't help what drops, so it's not going to be exactly the same. I might have either a little more, a little less caps than what I had before, but essentially it is the same character. There might be a few subtle differences, like I said, but here we go. So I just want to preface that so you guys know. So there's still going to be the freezing, you know, the pausing, and the occasional long loading screens like this one here. Usually if you're going into a new cell, it's going to take forever, but you know what? That's not the mod's fault, because I remember that doing it on console when I played it, you know, on console all those years ago. And even before, on PC, before even played with mods, you know, it would do that. Here we go.
Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me, anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Ellie.
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did?
Gotta give her a raise. Yeah.
Now, you mentioned something about your son, Shaun. How he went missing. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
Yes. Yeah, I'll follow you.
All right, let's move fast. Follow me.
Okay. I will follow you, and this way I can address you guys. But although I think I pretty much said everything that needed to be said. So I guess just to summarize again, I had to remove the crime and punishment mod because it was conflicting with the game. It was causing it to pause and freeze. Oh hey, fucking banter, I love it.
Always keep your eyes out, head on a swivel.
Sure. Okay, it was causing the game to pause for longer than usual and more frequently than usual. Oh, please, yes. Oh, good. I love it when he kills a legendary. Oh, hey! Junkie's pipe pistol does increasing amounts of damage the more withdrawal effects is up. But I'm not a junkie.
Where'd he go?
But, so I had to, oh shit. Okay, well, because I removed that mod, my game got corrupted. So I had to restart the game.
Despite the mayor's bragging, it really is.
From scratch, I had to start a new game. Are you gonna go? And I had to recreate my actions and the events up to this point. I tried picking the same dialogue choices and everything up to this point that you are seeing right now. So it's more or less the same. Look at the lighting. Wow. Look at the stars. I could see the stadium lights. Oh shit, maybe this was a bad idea to save it there. Okay, there. Get out of that. Out of the danger. Because, like, if you save it, like, right when there's an enemy, you could just load into a death. And I've had that happen. It's not good. Guys need help. Oh wow. What the? You miss. Picked up a skull or something. Oh, but that's not what's weighing me down. Okay, duelist raider right arm. 10% chance to disarm melee attacker on hit. Drop one. Ah, shit. Okay.
In the paper, right? You're 200 years old. Looking pretty good for your age, huh?
Okay, see. Like, right here, because it's changing, I don't know what, but changing perspectives or changing modes or something. Like, usually if I'm going to get out of my power armor, open up my Pip-Boy or go into the map or access a power station or crafting station like this, it will pause for a bit, maybe up to 20, see, like that, up to 20 seconds maybe, and then it's all good. But it always does that, and it doesn't do it all the time. It's like every so often, you know. But before, it would do it like quite a bit more often than usual, and also in like odd places, because I had that crime and punishment without the script extender. Okay, very good. Okay, I think, Piper, you have some stuff.
Hey.
What you got for me?
Wait there.
Oh, okay. Shit, no.
Come on.
Be here, then. Help yourself. Okay.
Really cool. Short barrel. Double barrel. Short. Same friggin' thing. Wonder if I could paint everything. Okay. Now that one still seems to be okay. Ooh. Ooh. I cannot repair the jetpack. Ouch. That sucks. So I really have to get whatever the, you know, the requirements to build a jetpack so I could repair it. All right. If I do this, will I have to repaint it? Let's find out. I don't. Okay. Really good to know. Sandboxing, right?
Everyone else may be closed, but Diamond City Surplus is open 24 hours a day.
Sure, let's take a look.
The highest quality available.
Right. I do hope that it's enough. taking that. Okay. There we go.
I ain't telling you how to pick your friends. Piper's kind of a troublemaker.
Looks like all of it. Okay, it's painted up. It doesn't look so rusted anymore. So I like that. Okay, the left arm. Now I have to do the right arm. Ooh. We have to do that another time.
Operator on board. Switching to manual piloting mode. All systems now.
Okay, are you ready, Piper? Oh, you were just standing there.
I hear there's a bar in the
grab the paper? Yeah, I'll grab it later. Hopefully, dawn is upon us. I don't even see where the clock is, but it's okay. Look at the sky. Oh, Valentine, you didn't have to wait for me.
Death. Someday death will laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
You're most welcome.
Happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into scary pre-war ruins all the time then, do you? Here. Every cap we agreed to for finding him.
Oh, hey.
Plus a little something extra.
Oh.
No. If you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat,
wow.
I sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
Right. Look at the detail in that. The sofa and everything.
Trying to find someone who's gone missing. The devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can. No matter how painful it might be.
I'll tell him everything. What she said, the devil is in the details.
My wife was murdered. She was trying to keep them from taking Shaun, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers, but they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. What else can you tell me?
That's right.
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much, but I remember they called me the backup.
So we're talking a small team, professionals, the kind that know to keep their lips tight when they're on the job. Not sure what the backup means, though. Anything else you remember?
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. it was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. A lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. Anything else you remember?
We're looking for my son, Shaun. He's less than a year old.
Why would I still think that?
Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders,
I heard about the Institute.
Super mutants, the gunners. And of course, there's the Institute.
Right. Well, I know about the Institute because of Piper. But why would I not know that? Why would I still think that Shaun is a baby? You know, I think I would know that he's grown up now, but...
Who were the gunners?
High-end mercenaries. No job too brutal. They're in the running as likely suspects. They wouldn't be the ones pulling the strings.
Hmm. So just, like, henchmen?
You think raiders might have done this?
I honestly doubt it. They can barely organize themselves, let alone pull off something this complicated.
Okay, so that leaves the raiders out, possibly gunners working with whoever, you know, murdered my wife and took my child.
Super mutants? What are they?
Big, green, muscles on muscles. In other words, hard to miss. I think we can safely rule them out.
Mm-hmm. And let's get down to it. The Institute.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. Discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal. And there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
I see.
Either way, I need to find Shaun.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
Okay.
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper across her face.
Not much to go on, but a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far in the violence business. What else?
The man who killed my wife. He had a handgun. I didn't get a clear look at it, but that sound...
Could have been a large caliber revolver. Huh. I'm starting to get a clearer picture of the kind of man our perp is. Anything more you can tell me?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
Bald, scarred.
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
Tell me about him.
Who is he? Do you think he has Shaun?
Way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
Any
bought a house here in town.
I gotta say.
He had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned wet stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
Uh-huh. Being interviewed like this, seeing this office, the secretary, it's just getting me more and more excited to start that gun for hire. You know, it's almost like I'll be doing the same thing and I'll be just right across the street from Diamond City.
Gave a girl waiting.
Oh, excuse me.
It's Shaun. It has to be. Somehow.
Don't jump the gun on me. You said you were looking for an infant, remember? That's over 9 years difference by my count. Look, maybe
well,
he
I'm
has a son
frozen
of
for nine more years.
Maybe it's someone else's kid. Either way, they both vanished a while back. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address.
Whoa.
See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
I love this. It, you know, as great as I think Skyrim is and was and still is, they've really improved upon the AI and the movements, the storytelling, I think is all stellar, top-notch. I really feel immersed in a different way than when I'm playing like Skyrim or Witcher, you know. I love those games, especially Skyrim. But because of how, and I guess because it's more like rooted, you know, and I use this term loosely, in more in reality than Skyrim. Skyrim being a fantasy game, this is a post-apocalyptic game, but I mean, I can relate more to the stuff, you know, my surroundings, you know, the vow cabinets, guns, you know, things like that. Of course, I can't relate to, you know, the tech that they have and synths and stuff like that, but I can relate more with my environment and what's around me. That combined with the brilliant AI, the looks, the animations and stuff, it really gets me even more immersed. And I mean, this just feels like I'm in a private detective's office, you know? I mean, and I really feel like...
You look like you're about ready to topple over.
I know this guy. You know, I'm really getting to know Kellogg, just like I'm... Not Kellogg, Valentine. Nick Valentine, just like I've slowly begun to know more about Piper. That Luxo home that I have, which I still have to do a toy video, but I think, I'm sure you don't mind. This is, you know, that I take some of this stuff. It is for the quest, right? Okay. It's for the quest. Come, brother. It's for the quest. Oh, hey. Okay, I'll take that and read that later. Is there a bobble around here? I won't take her fan because.
Lot, haven't you? Hope you and Nick find that monster.
Yes.
Oh hey. Yeah, I like that. It includes a game. Yeah, what is this?
The Earl Sterling case.
Okay.
Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
Hmm. Yeah, I'll take a look at that file. Maybe I can be a partner to him. To Nick. Anything else? Any bobbleheads around here?
You two be careful.
Okay. Save that. Let's get in here. I really have to use this power armor sparingly. Now that I know that I can't repair it. At least for now. Probably a good long while, but I think I need to make that my priority now. I think it's time I give this power armor a rest, and I'm gonna leave it in my Luxo after this. Okay, this is an excellent place to stop. You know, we rescued Valentine and took the long way, you know, back to Diamond City, you know, running back over here and encountering some enemies along the way. Helped out the Diamond City security with their little super mutant problem. It just all feels organic, you know. We're Nick and I running back, you know, he's leading me back to Diamond City. I don't know exactly, you know, where it is because I'm not familiar with the layout of things anymore, you know, waking up in this post-apocalyptic world, coming across, you know, some mutated dogs that attack us. And as we're nearing the city is, you know, under siege or under attack by super mutants, and I just go over there and help them out. It just, as I said, everything comes to me, like, organically, and I love it. What a beautiful shot this is. I might use this as a screenshot. I don't know. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Did I give the date? It is January 1st, 2023. I used to be really good at that, you know, giving the date at the beginning, and I got to remember to do that from now on. Anyways, I hope you guys had a happy new year and happy holidays and had a Merry Christmas. And, yeah, thank you.